guys, welcome back. Sorry. It is Friday once again. I feel like all we ever do is film like one time throughout the week and then we try and catch you guys up on Friday. So here's your weekly catch up. It's been a week. It's 4th of July this week and just really weird working the first 3 days of the week, having Thursday off, and then today is Friday, and so I had to go back to work today. And it felt like Monday all day, and there were five of us in the office, so super fun. We got lunch, and I gave blood today at work. American Red Cross comes to us, and we have like a setup in one of our conference rooms, and you can just go and give blood, which is really awesome. And so, plug for them, guys. The American Red Cross is short on blood. We're having a blood shortage. So if you are able and willing, please go donate, because literally, technically, you can save up to 3 lives every time you give, which is really awesome. And I like found out how, and it's because they like separate the blood into like components. Anyway, I don't know. So super exciting. But they also give you snacks afterwards, so everybody loves that. So why would you not give blood? You save lives, you give snacks, and you lose a pound, because they take a pound of your blood, basically. So many good reasons to donate. Go donate blood, guys. So let's back up for a second. So last week, well, actually the past couple weeks, life has just been really weird and crazy. You guys know I work at MU Healthcare, and I've been there, oh my gosh, officially tomorrow it'll be 2 months. 2 months ago tomorrow was my first day technically, because it was my orientation day. So you guys have been with me through that, and I do this weird thing, which I've done since I was like in my teens. I did it with my driver's test, is I don't tell anybody about things that are happening just in case they don't, and then I don't disappoint anybody and I don't have to go around telling people that X, Y, and Z didn't happen. So the reason I said that I've done this since I was in my teens is because I did it with my driver's test. So I didn't tell anybody I was taking my driver's test. I just took it. I mean, my mom knew, but I didn't tell any of my friends. But that being said, I was actually up for promotion a couple weeks ago in a really strange turn of events. And they asked me to apply for this job because the department head wanted to make me part of his team, which is really awesome. And I was like super honored. It wasn't really a position. It was a position that I wasn't going for, but then realized I wanted it after it was offered. And then I didn't really know if I wanted it. I'm not trying to downplay it, because at one point I was like, for sure, I'm on board. I want this. This is really exciting. Big promotion. I jumped a couple levels in the company. It was a pay raise. There's just like a lot of good things about it. There was a lot of difficult things that were going to come with it, and I think I had convinced myself that it was going to be okay. But you guys, I'm going to show you guys the footage of what happened, or I mean, like, I guess before my interviews and then after my interview. It is Tuesday at a couple minutes after 11. I am actually on my way to shadow at the hospital, because I had actually been interviewing for a promotion. So I had 2 interviews last week. This is actually, a huge promotion and something that I didn't expect at all, and something that was offered to me. So super excited. We're gonna see what happens, but would take a position as a recruiter, and I think it would just be super awesome and fun, and it was one of my favorite things to do, working as the HR director of Chick-fil-A, and just the interviewing process, but finding really great candidates and then telling really great candidates, yes, we want you to be a part of our organization, is just really fun. So really excited. We're gonna see what happens, but I think this is the final step, so we're gonna find out. We are back. It is after my meeting, multiple meetings, after lunch. I'm on my way back to work, and it went really well. So I actually met with four of the other recruiters. I had already met with the other four, well, the other three plus, she's an HRA, can't remember, but she works in the office and she helps. She's like a recruiter assistant. So I met with every single recruiter now, the recruiter manager, the director of talent acquisitions. All of this has happened within the past week, and tomorrow I have a phone call with the actual recruiter for the position. So we'll see what happens, and we'll see if she offers me a job. But it went really well, and I really like the people, and they're super kind, and I just want to be friends with all of them, and they're closer to my age. I'm definitely the youngest. But super cool, and yeah, guys, we're so excited. I don't know how to hold my phone apparently today, but yeah, really good things. And in the end, I didn't end up getting the promotion. So the best rejection I've ever gotten in my life, honestly. And again, I know the guy that's in charge of the department. And he called me and was like, hey, we think you'd be a great fit. It was very interesting. But he was like, but we're not offering you the position. And I was like, okay. And he was like, we just think that your talents are better suited in the department you're currently in. There's just a lot more room for growth and development. And in addition to that, I don't want to stick you behind a desk for the rest of your life. And I was like, okay, that's fair. So sticking it out right now, I'm kind of in a weird phase, and I'm not gonna lie, feeling a little lost. So if you guys have ever graduated college, there's like, you feel like you should know what you're doing. And I like did for a hot minute, and then just hit the curb. Sorry, I promise I'm a good driver. But it's just weird because I thought I knew what I was doing, and then all of a sudden I'm starting to feel lost, and there's just like a lot going on, I guess. And so I'm happy with where I'm at, and I know I'm growing a lot, but just trying to pursue some opportunities and find out what's going on and figuring out my next steps in the trajectory of what I want my career to be. And so it's just interesting because I thought I'd have this figured out now. So hashtag real talk with you guys. But yeah, so it's been a time. It's been a good couple weeks. A really good, hard growing couple weeks, but like leaning into the Lord a lot. A lot of journaling, which is something I go through spurts with, and just asking a lot of questions, but just being really honest with God and being like, hey, I'm really lost right now, and I don't know how to fix this, and I know that I can't do anything to fix this, and anything that's going on in my heart, like, hey, I need you to calm it down, but also I need you to give me guidance on what your will is for my life and how to move forward. So he's faithful, and he's been good up until now, and so I don't think he's not going to be good. But just figuring out what is next, which is a question I thought I was asking myself, and I know I was asking myself this a couple months ago before I graduated, and now I'm asking myself all these questions again. So just a really interesting time, guys. Life just ends up in a different way than you thought it would, you know? So okay, we're back again. So I started doing this thing on Friday nights because Katie works nights at the hospitals, and we can't hang out on Friday nights because, well, she's at the hospital working. But I take Friday nights to myself now, as opposed to any other Friday night, I guess. But I actually go and I leave the house and I go and sit at a coffee shop, and I journal and I read and I listen to music, and I just kind of like hang out with myself. I hang out with myself, I guess, all the time. But there's just something really sweet about being able to sit after a really long week at work, after having worked really hard, and just sitting and journaling and praying. And like I said, all of these lost feelings are great to process on Friday nights, I guess. So I put on a long sleeve shirt and Nike shorts and a baseball hat because, well, I just couldn't stand my hair any longer today. But Yeah, so we're gonna finish this vlog tonight, actually, with our workout routine. So this is only part of it. We just decided to film it because we do pretty much the same thing every time we go to the gym. I pretty much go every day after work. They told me I wasn't allowed to go today because I gave blood. And so, well, I didn't because I'm a rule follower. But we go and we normally do the stair stepper for, it varies, at least 15 minutes. We've done like a 30 minute stair stepper workout, which is horrible. That was also a horrid face, I'm sure. and then, so I'll normally go for like 15 minutes or so, and then I'll get off and run for 10 minutes. Katie will just stay on like the whole time. And then we go sit in the sauna because our gym currently has sucky hours because it's summer. And so we're just like super strategic about when we do what. Anyway, so we sit in the sauna and then we go and do like this core, legs, shoulders, arms. I don't know, guys. I just work out the same parts of my body every day. And I know you're not supposed to do that, but I do. So we just decided to film it. And it's fun to do with somebody. I'll do this when Katie's not there. But it's fun to do with somebody there too. So we just do like Russian twists, I guess, and like crunches and planks with a kettle. I don't know. You guys will, you're about to watch it. Anyway, but we thought it'd be something fun for you guys to see what we do because we really do work out when we go to the gym. And it's hard, but it's fun. And it's way more motivational if you have a buddy. So find yourself a gym buddy and get to it, y'all. So happy Friday again. Thanks for watching. As always, subscribe. Tell your friends. Tell your mom. Tell your dad. And thanks, guys. We really appreciate it. We're kind of going strong. It's just crazy because vlogging is not our full-time jobs, like some other influencers, I guess. But we can do our small part and vlog a little bit here and there and post once a week. It's hard, just to be honest. But we like it. And we've gotten some really great feedback, meaning our friends really like it because people that don't live near us and that we don't talk to every day, this is kind of how they figure out what's going on with our lives. So thanks for watching, guys. Follow us on Instagram. See you next week.
Hey, where's the drums?
You're never going out of style. Ooh, pretty baby, this world might have gone crazy. The way you saved me, who could blame me when I just wanna make you smile? I wanna thrill you like Michael. I wanna kiss you like Prince. Let's get it on like Marvin Gaye, like Hathaway. Write a song for you like this. You're over my head, I'm out of my mind. Thinking I was wrong in the wrong time. One of a kind, living in a world gone plastic. Baby, you're so classic.
Yeah, yeah, so
baby, you're so classic.
Yeah, yeah.
Baby, you're so classic. 4,000 roses, anything for you to notice. All the way to serenade you, doing it's not your style. I'ma pick you up in a Cadillac like a gentleman. Bring it glamour back, keep it real to real in the way I feel. I could walk you down the aisle. I wanna do you like Michael. I wanna kiss you like Prince. Let's get it on like Marvin Gaye, like Hathaway. Write a song for you like this. You're over my head.
I never met a girl like you ever till we met. A star in the 40s and a fold in the 50s. Got me tripping out like 60s. Let me